Welcome back to Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Today's episode, powered by Hayabusa, is about how to beat a better boxer with your kicks. Five different kick fighting strategies. Today's episode, we're going to talk about kick fighting strategies. In modern martial arts, it's not good enough to say someone has better hands than me and I can't beat that person. If someone has better boxing than you, right away you should be thinking, how can I use my kick fighting to beat that opponent? And that's what today's video is on. I'm going to give you five different strategies which I think are the most important five to be able to approach an opponent or a fight like this. Okay, so the first thing you have to understand is understanding range. When you fight someone that has better boxing than you, you have to either be all in or all out. What does all in mean? All in means utilizing that clinch. So getting to that clinch, tying up their hands is very important, especially if they're used to a lot of boxing. By fatiguing the shoulders, getting the arms tired, you're gonna take a little bit of steam away from the punches. Also, by grabbing their neck, pulling them in, tying them up, they can't punch you, so all the way in. Okay? The safest way to not get hit with those shots. The second way is all the way out. Okay, so you're managing that distance. Don't stay in mid-range against that boxer. Clinch, exit. On that outside range, you have to use certain types of footwork that we always talk about on the channel. So a lot about a triangle stepping, right? Hit, get out, neutral stance, move, and exit. Okay, double stepping back, managing double distance are all important concepts to stay out of range against. Okay, so managing your distance, all in or all out, strategy number one. Strategy number two against the boxer is now using your kicks to counter their hands. You want to shut down the hands. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna make sure I shut down the jab. And that's what usually flows people's hands in combinations. They like to throw that lead hand first. So the way as a kick fighter I like to shut that down is by using the low kick or the body kick. Shut that jab down. So as soon as the jab comes out, right away I rip that leg right on that first time. So they know every time they jab, I'm gonna punish that lead leg. Right? It's a little bit dangerous at first because they have a lot of pop and a lot of power. A lot of times after that jab, that right hand comes right down the middle. So by chopping, moving, staying long is very important. As the fight goes on, as they lose, you know, a lot of power in their punches and you get more confidence in your defense, which is a key in kick fighting, you're able to stay more in that mid-range to be able to use and counter your kicks. So ideally when countering punches versus kicks, I like to take from the jab, I like to use my rear kick. So I'll chop the leg, the calf, or the body kick. Now when they throw their cross, that's where I like to use my left kick and change it on levels. Ideally, I'm attacking the liver or the inside leg to off balance, but I'm gonna use my kicks to counter the punches. Strategy number three when kick fighting versus a boxer. I talk about countering punches versus kicks in the last strategy, but it's also important to use front kicks. If you throw too many round strikes against a boxer, what's gonna happen is they're gonna pressure in, right? They need to get closer because your legs are a longer weapon, the hands are shorter, they need to come into your range. So this is where you need to use front kicks. Your front kick is one of your longest weapons that you have. So by using that spearing weapon, it keeps them away. If everything is coming round on your opponent, it's easy for them to pressure inside. Just like our boxing, if I'm throwing round punches, so visualize these as kicks, right? It's easy to come right down the middle. But if I'm every so often throwing a straight punch down the middle, it's very hard for my opponent to come in because they're gonna eat that straight punch. So same concept with the kicks. If I'm gonna keep firing around, countering off these round kicks, I need to make sure I throw some front kicks down the middle to establish that range in the distance. So ideally, these front kicks are gonna help you with all of the steps before, you know, with managing the distance, in or out, with being able to counter your punches, be able to chop the legs, all very important. So use that front kick to mix in the round attacks. The other good thing about the front kick is they work the knees really well. So if they're gonna continue to pressure, they'll help you set up and use knee feints as well to get, you know, punish them for trying to get in on the inside is the key. The fourth strategy when kick fighting against the boxer is using push-off attacks. So as I mentioned, the first thing is closing that distance, getting the clinch. But once I have that clinch, I just don't want to stop. I want to be able to create some offense and to attack. So the safest way for me to kick someone versus punches is to kick them on their exit. If I'm waiting for them to come forward and I kick, they're probably gonna push me backwards. They're on 2 feet jamming forward as I'm trying to kick on one leg. That means I'm falling back. It's not looking good on the judge's scorecard. So I need to pick my timing for my kicks really carefully. So when I tie them up in the clinch, I'm gonna use that push off attack and kick. As they're falling backwards, they're not able to put the power forward to land you with your hand, and they'll be too far to hit. So now I'm able to either chop the leg off a push off kick or push off head kick, and then I can manage that distance as well. And then I repeat the sequence, you know? Attack, safe enter to the clinch, push off attack, go back in, safe enter. So I keep repeating the process. So I'm always managing the distance from in, out, tying up their hands and using front kicks and those counter push off kicks as well. The fifth and final strategy that I like to use as a kick fighter against the boxer is what I call cracking the shell and my knees. So what happens here in cracking the shell is you intentionally throw your arm kicks to the arm. You want to kick the arms as hard as you can. Break the form. Boxers a lot of times aren't used to blocking kicks in the heavy. They're used to parrying, maybe using different types of movement and feinting, but a good arm kick is gonna shut a boxer down. As soon as they even go to think to punch, I'm kicking the arm, especially in a north versus south style fight. If I'm fighting a southpaw, my rear kick is open and loaded. I'm gonna blast that kick off that rear side. I'm gonna shut down their rear power side by constantly kicking their arm, kicking the arm. That's a strategy we see a lot in Thailand. This cracking the shell, because it shut down boxers right away. If they go to think to throw in a kick's coming, they're gonna wanna hesitate that power side. So by learning to stay long, crack the shell, you get to keep the boxer's hands pinned. Or the boxer's hands pinned to them, it's really hard for them to open up if you're constantly hitting them off the guard. So front kick, round kick, keep cracking that shell as hard as you can. Shut the offense down. And the beautiful thing about that shell is it sets up the knees, because from the shell position, what does the boxer have to do? They have to fight out of the shell. So from the shell, eventually they're gonna have to blast up and open. So using the crack in the shell style to time some knees as they go to open up the punches is the good strategy as well. But you need to, telling you, be very careful with that type of strategy. You have to time it well. If you are going to throw a knee as someone's throwing a big power punch, here, my hands come here and I eat that shot, too dangerous. So it's good to be able to land them. So a lot of times I like to force my knee. I'll do a jumping knee, or I'll force my knee going forward just to kind of jam the punches. But just be cautious that a counter to the knee is a big bombing punch. But knees are effective if you use them properly versus a boxer. Okay, so make sure you keep liking and subscribing to Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Make sure you like, subscribe, and support our channel sponsors. Go to HayabusaFight.com and make sure you check out their T3 boxing gloves and their T3 line, as well as Perfect Sports Nutrition, 20% off by using the code BAZOOKA20 to get all your supplements. And make sure you tell your friends, tell your family, and let's keep growing Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA.